Hi there! In the last two videos, we had a look at how we can use text styles and font weights in Unity's TextMesh Pro. Amazing as they are, if you're not used to writing text, they can be a bit daunting to get correct and looking good. Let's build a tiny tool that will automate this process for us. At the end of this tutorial, we will have built this here. A script you can throw on a game object that has a TMP text component attached, and it will generate the text based on our choices. You'll just have to copy-paste them, since there is currently no way to automate that particular part. The neat thing is, you only need the script rarely. Thus, I'm fine with it living its life as a mono behavior instead of building a dedicated editor tool. Set your style up once, copy-paste, and remove the component afterwards. We start at creating a new script, of course. I'll call mine TMP Style Sheet Creator Prototype because I like descriptive names. Once it works, I'll rename it and remove the prototype part. First, we'll need to give it the TMP component to work with, followed by a string for the opening and closing tags. Next is the main function, read values from TMP. It gets two string builders, one for opening and one for closing tags. In my opinion, working with a string builder felt more intuitive to me than just the string. To start, let's have this function read if I bolded my text. It works like this. First, have it check if I am using a font style and if that style is bold. If I do, write the corresponding tags for bold into the opening and closing string builder. I made a cheat sheet of which tags correspond to which button. You'll find it in the video description. Have fun! Lastly, write the contents of the string builders to the corresponding strings. To be able to use the script from the editor, for example via drop-down menu, let's write this line above our function. And we're basically done with our first prototype. Back in Unity, let's create a new TMP text. I highly recommend starting with a clean new component and not with one you might have already used styles on for this. My personal workflow always uses a new text for it to start from and style it like I want the end result to look like. Alright, done. Let's bold the text, attach our script, and use our newly created function. Looks like expected. I hope yours does too. Back in the code, let's add all the text styles we usually need. No need to bloat this tool. I'll limit myself to the few options I use the most. As you can see, converting the completed string builders to strings is now down below here. These two lines will always stay at the bottom of our function. Once done, test your code. There shouldn't be any troubles at this point. Onward to the next asset, which can be a bit tricky, I admit. As you can see, when you created a font asset in TMP, this part gets added. But if we want to use it as a font name for our font tag, we need to get rid of it, since it doesn't work if we keep it. Thus, we will replace it with emptiness. Font size is super easy though, we can just read the value. Color, on the other hand, is less intuitive. First, we need to read the value, then convert it to an RGB color that works with TMP's tags. Finally, add it to our string builders like this. Test your script if it works. Next on the list is spacing, or more concrete, character and line spacing. In my rough decade of being a print designer, I never came across a font that wouldn't have been improved by adding just a little bit of extra character spacing, also called kerning, or line spacing. It makes fonts more readable if you don't overdo it. I've never come across a text that actually needed more word spacing though, and paragraph spacing really is more for very long text, I say. Not typically something I'd encounter in games. I am on a German system, so when I had the code divide the spacing by 100, which we need because of the way TMP uses these values, I get a comma value. Trouble is, TMP doesn't like comma values in its tags. That's why I need to add this part here. Culture info in variant culture turns the comma into a dot, while n3 tells the string to only have 3 decimal values. That's enough for us to give us all the detail we need while keeping stuff readable. Those are all the values I typically need, so I'll stop here. One thing I want to add though, which is not a button in TMP, font weights. I made a video about them here, you might want to check it out to understand the following bit. Since I want to use different weights, like bold, heavy or black, I add this at the top of the script. To make it work, I'll add this enum below my script too. I won't use it anywhere else in my project, so this location is fine with me. Usually, I don't choose anything below regular when working on text for monitors, since readability starts suffering quickly. Bold can already be achieved by pressing this button on the UI, so I won't bother with it. But I'll need an option to pick either black or thin. We also need an option for none, in case we don't actually want to use any different font weights. Back in our reading function, we'll add these lines here. They will check if we picked a different weight, and if we did, our choice will get added to the opening and closing tags. Alright, time to check our progress. I'll style my text in a way I want it to look in my project. Call our function, and we'll get all the text we need. Yay! Copy and paste them either to a new style, or override some other style with them. At this point, I'll get rid of my text prototype as well as the prototype part of my script name. It works well enough for my needs. You could go nuts with this, of course. Create a dedicated panel for it, add more styles, alignments, and all the bells and whistles you enjoy. But for me, I enjoy my tools simple and straight to the point. I hope you enjoyed this and that creating new styles will now be something you'll actually be looking forward to. Please hack the subscribe button if you haven't done so already. But if you did, thank you so very much. It brings a smile to my face seeing people enjoying my content. Hope to see you soon!